Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to F1 22 My Team Career Mode for the mid-season race, the Austrian Grand Prix. Yes, I almost said Australian. This is another sprint round. In the first sprint race, I didn't do so well. If you remember, it was the land of the Scuderia Ferrari, and the Ferrari sucked as usual. I ended up sticking it on pole position in qualifying. However, in the sprint race, me and Max made contact. I ended up getting a pretty good result in the sprint race. However, I made a little oopsie in the actual race, which led to us having to pit again. So we ended up having to have a second pit stop, and we finished fifth. That is my lowest finish all season so far. I am not trying to do any worse. I want to do much better every race. Other than that, other than Imola, I have finished either first or second this season. This is like the first time that I have at least finished in the points every single race so far. Only other season was season one, and that record was dropped right here in Austria. I am not trying to have that same issue happen again. The points stand at a 31-point gap between myself and Verstappen. Hee hee! It is looking like I am going to be the Season 3 World Champion. However, things can turn around just like that. Hopefully it doesn't. But fate will have it that I've had a lead like this before, and it did not work. So, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to do this race, and you are going to like this video, and you are going to subscribe to my channel, and I will gift you my song. Coming soon. Anyways, here we go. Austrian GP. 3, 2, 1. Here we go! Five red lights here at the F1 sprint, and it's lights out and away we go. Here for the Austrian sprint, Verstappen gets the jump into turn one. Sergio Perez and Red Bull trying to get max point, as much points as they possibly can here. We're going to shove our teammate off to reclaim the lead of the race. we are going to begin to drive away from Verstappen.
driver's standings. Martin increases their championship lead. It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Another team that excelled today were Williams, who make further progress up the table. Well, that wraps up the sprint. All that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
Five red lights, and it's lights out, and away we go. Verstappen has to start at the back due to grid penalties. That is going to allow us to possibly gain a lot of points on our teammate. I can already see that he hasn't moved, that he isn't waiting, as he has made up quite a bit of ground already. Go on to start lap two now. Charles Leclerc has wrestled his way ahead of the two McLarens. Okay, so Max is already back into the points, and currently P8. He has made up a lot of ground. Thank you. Well, that changes everything. We had a spinner. Looks like one of the Alphataris. It is lightly raining in that area of the track. If it gets any worse, then I might think of putting the intermediates on. Because it's starting to... But I'm not seeing any raindrops forming on the halo. But what I am feeling is the track's starting to get a little iffy. And the team has decided to keep me out and box Verstappen, even though I am leading the race. Don't think I agree with that. Gearbox is starting to show its wear and tear. Here we go then. Come on guys, fast stop, fast stop. Thank you. So Max currently stands in only P6. He's right behind Ricardo. So I think Max may only be able to get a P5 finish, P4 at the most. But he has to get past Ricardo first. There it is. Max makes the move, and he is past the Australian. However, Ricardo does not seem to like that idea. Max is going to have to get him with DRS. Laps are winding down. Max has to make the move. Ricardo is not gonna pit again. He's going to be here the rest of the race. Ricardo is not in the championship battle, yet he is playing a very important role within the championship here in Austria, because I am leading currently, and Verstappen is struggling to stay ahead of Ricardo for P5. I think Verstappen may have gotten him now. Now Max can set his sights on his old teammate of Sergio Perez. We now have a 3-second time penalty. Yeah. Mock. Jesus. Ugh. Ooh, hair in the face. Never fun. Oh, come on! Slippery fingers. Verstappen has caught Sergio Perez. I'm sure that Max will be able to make the move with DRS. Verstappen now clears Perez and sets his sights on trying to chase after the two other podium drivers. F- 3 laps to go here in Austria. We are now starting to catch some of the back markers. We caught the back markers in Canada. It was Latifi in the Haas, and Latifi did not exactly want to get out of the way. In fact, he actually hit me and almost caused me the race win. Verstappen is closing the gap between himself and Leclerc and Norris. Pretty easy move on Oscar Piastri. We're going to try to slide past Pierre Gasly. Coming to the final lap of the race. Oh no. Hi Latifi, please don't hit me again like you did last time. Thank you. Final lap of the race. Here we go. It's a 31.5 second gap over Lando Norris. We're going to send it underneath Zhou Guan Yu. This is going to be the seventh win in a row here this season for ourselves. We're going to come through to gain more points on Verstappen and win again for the seventh time consecutive. And we win again in the Red Bull Ring. Max Verstappen is your driver of the day, obviously, with all those positions he's gained.
Have a look then at the driver standings. Martin increases their championship lead.
go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Max Verstappen's solid, clean driving throughout the event.
It's time to check out the constructor standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
So... five drivers this season have yet to get points. And in the constructors, Haas is the only team who has not scored any points whatsoever this so far this season. We have just hit the 500 point mark, and we are now 254 points ahead of McLaren. And in the Drivers' Championship, we gain up to a 46 point lead now over Verstappen. When is it going to end? Seven consecutive race wins. Only two more to tie the record, which is held by Sebastian Vettel from 2013. Can we do it? I am going to say I think we can. Also, in the Constructors' Championship, the fight for fifth might have just got kicked back up because Red Bull have had their first double points race in the first for the first time in a long time. It's been a long time since we've seen both Red Bulls finish in the points. And with Esteban Ocon not really helping his teammate of Alexander Albon, and with Jehan Daravola possibly finally settling in, and Perez having brought many points to the team already, Red Bull is only 4 points behind Alpine in the Constructors' Championship. This is not looking good for Alpine, as they can't seem to get their secondary driver of Ocon to kickstart his season. It is very, very disappointing for the young French driver. But even more upsetting for the young Thailand driver, who has to carry the Constructors' championship hopes of a top five on his back, all on his own. So I'm sure Albon is getting upset with Alpine.